what's going on. It's Kurt from Kurt Yall Medical Adventures. As you can see, I'm in the hospital again. I'm sitting here at Rose Medical Center, and I'm thinking I have a shunt malfunction, which I should really be addressing. So that's kind of the situation here. I'm gonna take you along for the ride as I go for a CT scan. But you know, it's just one big gong show. So let me hop in the wheelchair here. I'm popping wheelies now. I feel like absolute hell right now. Yeah, I'm just sitting back and heading off to CAT scan. Oh. Yeah, I'm just that was easy. Hey, I gotta talk to you guys later. We're already at CAT scan. Hey guys, I'll talk to you later on. Kurt Yall Medical Adventures signing off. Understand, Commander, that VPL shunt did not self-destruct. You heard it hit my pleural cavity, and I was never here. Contact Children's. Give them the go that I'm coming in hot. Not. I'm going to be here for a while.
Oh, we said a laser shot?
Yeah.
That combined with, you said a slightly lower elevation than he was at home, which we just didn't have, but living right above sea level.
And what was the term?
Polycythemia.
Polycythemia, so...
Too many red bloods.
Shoot.
The opposite of
anemia. Yeah. Yeah.
This guy's second word that he ever spoke
was stethoscope.
That's a kid that's been in the hospital too much.
So the bottom line is the headaches are not from the neurosurgeons think it's probably some other. Oh, so getting back to the polycythemia, who's this main doctor then?
Dr. Floyd.
How easy is it to get into her? As I feel safe sending you home, I don't want you to misunderstand, but I am kind of worried about the polycythemia.
Okay.
But that's kind of crazy at a high level, but I think it'd be best if you just followed up with her. This, now, when I say her, that clinic this week, I would see whether she was fine.
So tomorrow would be
sure
for the
call, or should I try to do it? Oh, no, I think tomorrow's okay. Now, what to do about that? You're an expert on your headaches. What should I do? I know that sounds weird for the doctor to ask you that, but you know your body.
Yeah, and I do know my body, and you're the first doctor to even pose the question to me.
Yeah.
So number one kind of catches me off guard. Number two, it's like, May God have grace, Halla frickin' Eula. Just, I have been fighting and fighting with my mom over here. Just, it seems like no one wants to believe me.
I know she believes it.
It's a matter of finding the right person. You see that you get to pay appropriate for that kind of headache. So you pretty much eliminate your strength headache, although I know that it feels to you probably like the strength headache. So let's look at the other thing. Let's first start with where the pain is. Can you point to it on your head?
It's right across the eyebrows, kind of like a tension headache. But
it seems like a tension headache.
Is it simply like pretty much right behind those eyebrows?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So that's actually a different area from what you told me earlier.
Fire alarm. You're gonna like this. Do you know what buildings have the least amount of gas?
Really?
It's extremely rare. Believe it or not, that causes anyone a great harm. But it is one of the safest places. It's a weird thing. And I always chuckle when I hear them going crazy over this. But that's probably part of the reason. And it's on the fourth floor is where this lot is.
Yeah.
And it's usually somebody burnt something in the microwave.
Yeah.
Popcorn. Usually it's popcorn.
Yeah.
So.
Popcorn burning on the second floor, Mr. Gallagher, yeah. Mr. Gallagher.
Yeah, right.
But also balloons.
But I found out this is really true. There's never been, there hasn't, it's extremely rare to have a serious injury from a fire in the hospital.
Yeah.
Extremely rare. You probably can't think of one where it happened. In the United States. In other countries, yes. In the United States, it just doesn't happen. And oxygen is flammable, believe it or not. Anyway, I feel the bottom line is I feel okay sending you home if you want to try and work with this headache.
Yeah.
We've ruled out emergencies. But that said, I'm willing to prescribe. I mean, I would personally, if you can take ibuprofen and Tylenol, I would try those for that medicine.
So tell me more about this one, though. You were saying that this is.
It's directly underneath my skin.
Okay.
Like, not even through my skull.
Okay, so it's just real surface, and what kind of metal is
it? I would give it probably a 10.
It's really intense, but pretty super, not superficial in that it's not a lot of pain, but it's just right there.
Correct.
I think that getting in home would be a good idea. I think that the one thing that you need to do when you get home is get some sleep.
Yes. I'm worried you're going to go back to the ham radio thing and make your stress. Is it over now?
No, it's got 4 more hours to go.
Yeah, well, let it go. Yeah. Our doctor's orders, home and rest.
Have you put that in the
description? Oh, shut up.
No, seriously, because Chris memory is like in the lowest 1% of the population. So we can show him that.
Okay, no ham radio. So your headache's gone.
Okay?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.